Tip over, tip over, tip over, tip over, tip over. Dang it! Mind control foiled again! Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. I've wanted to control things with my mind since forever. Well, mostly since I saw Matilda when I was a kid. While I don't have superpowers, maybe technology can help me out. Brain-computer interfaces, or BCI, are just like that sounds, devices that connect your brain to a computer. They can read your mind and make things move. While it might seem like a fantasy, it's 2016, baby, and it's here. It's real, and they have many uses. They are often a powerful aid to those with severe disabilities that inhibit movement, like quadriplegic injuries or those with cerebral palsy. They help people communicate, walk, and even drive a car. Seriously, recently Chinese researchers introduced a prototype for a mind-controlled car. This particular technology uses an EEG, or electroencephalogram, made up of 16 sensors on a cap that reads electric signals from the brain. Just by thinking, the controller can make the car move forward and backward and even come to a stop. But before you get too excited, the researchers from Nankai University don't intend to actually produce one of these cars. It was more a practice in seeing how useful such a tech can be, especially for those with disabilities. Although BCI tech was first researched in the 1970s, it's come a long way in the past few decades. They work by measuring the signals brain waves give off. These kinds of brain-computer interfaces can't read your every thought, but they can take all that electrical buzz from your brain and translate it into a single command, like walk forward, with alarming accuracy. But a lot of what's picked up is fuzzy white noise from other brain signals or electrical signals given off from muscles moving. An algorithm filters the noise from the notion, and that notion has to be sustained, a conscious, intentional activity. According to research given at the annual international conference of the IEEE Engineering and Medicine and Biology Society, some EEGs can translate intention 98% of the time. Now people like paraplegic individuals can browse the web and write emails by moving a mentally controlled mouse. But it's still a slow-going and cumbersome process. The system has to learn the patient's signals too. Both the patient and the computer are learning the process at the same time, so it can take months of practice and training. Because many BCI spelling systems flash different letters on a screen, and you have to think something like yes for the letter you want. The BCI reads that change in your brainwaves. So you can imagine that it would take time just to write your name. Some systems reportedly take a minute just to type out less than 10 characters. As for walking, EEG-controlled exoskeletons help people who've lost control of their legs walk again. But they take a whole crew of physical therapists to help wire someone into the machine, so they aren't just high-tech toys. But if you're more curious about the novelty factor, this tech is already hitting the toy market. Like the car can only go forwards or backwards, toys like Star Wars Science Force Trainer only send a ball blowing up a tube, but more complicated gadgets are on the horizon. One study published in the Journal of Neural Engineering found that a person can control a drone through an obstacle course just by the power of their thoughts. How cool is that? We know you love watching online, but we're excited to announce DNews is now on Science Channel. Trace and Amy will be sharing a minute of the best in science in between awesome programming. So check out as Science presents DNews at 9 every weeknight, Monday through Friday, and use your Twitter to let them know if you want more. So the power of the mind is pretty awesome, but your mind isn't the only way to control tech. The human body is full of kinetic energy, potential energy, heat, and electricity. Maybe we can use these resources for energy. To find out more about how your body can be a power plant, check out this episode right here.
The PZT uses millimeter scale batteries and a flexible base to generate and store electrical energy from human motion.
If they implant a PZT onto a heart muscle, the beating of the heart would produce enough electricity to power a pacemaker or a biometric sensor.
So I really want to know, have you used one of these mind control gadgets? Do they live up to your expectations? Let me know down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons so you don't miss a single DNews episode.